Hello, in this video, we will learn how to create any character pattern in Python. Now, when you search the internet, you see so many programs on character patterns. So do you need to learn all of them? Answer is no. You need to learn a few tricks and you can solve most of the character pattern program on your own. If you go through this video, you would be able to make any of these patterns shown. And I will explain to you how. When you are solving character pattern program, you will notice there are actually two things which make the pattern. One is the pattern or shape, and second is the character which are there inside the pattern. Like over here, the characters are same, but they are in different pattern. Or here the pattern is same, but each of the triangles have different characters. If you are new to character pattern programming, first thing you need to remember is that you should not mix the code for these two. Means your program will have two separate logic, one to make the pattern and other to put in the character as per the question. So let's get started. First thing we need to learn is pattern. It is the shape which contains the characters. As we just saw, the question can ask you same character in any different shape. So first thing you necessarily need to know is how to form that shape with basic star. If you have not watched my video to create any star pattern program using Python, you need to pause, click on the link given, watch that video and then return. It is very important that you first know how to create the shape with just star, as we are going to just reuse that code over here, adding the character part. I am giving a quick summary of my star pattern video. What we learnt is that you can make any complex shape by learning to code two basic shapes, increasing triangle and decreasing triangle. Let's see the code for both of them. Increasing triangle has outer loop which has range function till n and inner loop till I plus 1. Decreasing triangle have range function of outer loop till n and inner loop from I to n. Inside the inner loop, we have the print statement with end is equal to space to print the star, and the last statement of the outer loop is an empty print statement which takes you to the next line after a complete row is printed. You need to remember these two pattern codes. Any complex pattern is just broken down to these basic triangles and then just club together in sequence as they appear. For example, here we have first triangle with decreasing space and second triangle with increasing star. So we will write two inner loop like this. If it is a hill pattern, there is another decreasing triangle, so we will put another inner loop. To ensure we have pointed edges, we will have one of the loops print one less column. This code will give an output like this. So when you are given a character pattern, I will assume you do know how to create the shape with star, and we are going to just reuse that code to build a character pattern program. Second thing you need to know is that you typically have incrementing and decrementing character patterns. Now character is string. How do you increment or decrement it? For this, we use the ASCII code of characters. In computers, ASCII code represent text. So 65 is the code for capital A, 66 is the code for capital B, and so on. And similarly, 97 is the ASCII code for small a, 98 for small b, and so on. We will use these codes for making a pattern, and then during printing, just use the char function to convert it back to character. You need to remember these codes to make the pattern. Just learn the code for capital A and Z and small a and Z, and remaining you can just derive from them. Now let's see how we will handle character pattern program. Let's start easy with a single character pattern. Suppose it was pattern of just A's. When you solve pattern program with character, you will break your problem into two parts. First, what is the pattern? And second, what are the characters in it? You will first look at the shape and write the code which is required for that shape. As you see, this is increasing triangle pattern program. We will first get the star pattern program for increasing triangle we had learnt in the star pattern video. So this program solves the first part of creating the pattern. Now we will come to characters. We see that this has constant same character in the pattern. So only change you need to do here is, instead of star print character A, which is there, and you are ready with the pattern code. Now you do know different pattern programs from my star pattern program video. This effectively means that in any of those, if you replace star with A in print statement, you can have varied pattern shapes with A. Now this was too easy. Let's see something more closer to what is actually asked in the exam. Let's take a closer look at this pattern. Again, to solve this, we break it into two parts, pattern and characters. You know this is incrementing triangle pattern, so you can immediately recall the code which displays incrementing triangle pattern with star. Incrementing triangle has outer loop range function till n and inner range function till I plus 1. Now that we have the pattern sorted, we will focus on the character. What we see is that character starts with A and is incremented by 1 in each row. So we need A to be printed in row 0, B to be printed in row 1, and C in second, and so on. Now which of our loops manages the rows? It is the outer loop. What we will do is use another value P outside the loop and initialize it to the first value that is expected. Here it is A, so you put the ASCII code for A, which is 65 as we learned earlier. Inside the inner loop, we will replace star with the variable P, but we will convert it into char using the char function, otherwise it will print its ASCII code 65. Our end parameter will continue to have space if we want these to be evenly spaced. Now we know the last statement of outer loop is an empty print statement to take us to the next row. So here what we do is increment RP by 1 to get ready for next row. Now when you run it, it will give the output as shown. The same logic we can use for any shape which has the same character in each row, like for the right-sided triangle or hill pattern or any other pattern. Now what if the values were E first and then D and then C, B, A? Again we see in a row the same character is printed, so we will set P to the initial value of E, that is ASCII code 69, and in the inner loop we will print char P. Along with moving to the next row, we will decrement P by 1 for the next row. This will again work for all decreasing row character patterns. Let's take some different pattern this time. Now in this, first row starts with A and then next row is C and then E, G and I. Here again, we will take the shape pattern program and then we will set the initial value of P to A, means ASCII code 65. In print statement, instead of star, we will print char P. After printing, when we move to the next row, this time we will increment P by 2. Now let's go a little more complex. What if the pattern was like this? Now here there is no set increment or decrement, but it is just two values which are alternating. It could be numbers, patterns, or characters. How do we handle this? Let's pick one of them and study it closely. Now we do know how to make this pattern with star. Now in row 0, 2 and 4, I want A, and in 1 and 3, I want B. So what it is saying is that for even rows print A and odd rows print B. So what we need to do in such scenarios is just add a if else around the print statement. We will say if I is even, means if I percent 2 equal to 0, then print A, otherwise print B. With just this change, you have your code ready. Now what if the pattern was like this? Again take the code you have for the pattern first. Here in even rows we have Z, so we will have the if statement printing Z, else it will print 0. Now, how does this work in bigger pattern like diamond or butterfly pattern? Let's take diamond pattern as example. Here we have our star pattern code for diamond. Here, instead of star, the expectation is to print increasing characters in row. Now we have two outer loops here. Can you just in both loop write P starting from A means ASCII code 65, replace star with printing char P and increment P before last print? If you run this, your pattern will show up like this. Till D it was fine, but then it again started from A. The lower loop was supposed to increment and use previous P and not take a new P. So how will we fix this? We know we cannot declare P again for second loop, so we need to use one P for both of the outer loops. So what we will do is remove the initialization of P outside the second outer loop so that the first one is available to both loops. The increment will stay as is, as we need P to increment after each row. What if the pattern was like this? It is increasing and then decreasing. Here we again take our star pattern code for diamond, which builds the shape for us. I'm printing them in two columns so that you can see the complete code in one screen. Now first we have increasing character pattern. So what we are going to do is, before the first loop, we will set P to A means ASCII code 65. We will replace all print star with print char P. Before going to the next row, we are going to increment P. Now in the second loop, we have decreasing characters. By the end of the first outer loop, P has already reached the value of E. So in the second loop, we will just replace print star with print char P everywhere. Before moving to the next row, now we decrement P every time. This is our code for increasing and decreasing character patterns. You can try the alternating characters, skipping characters, and try playing around with double row patterns. Now all this was where character in a row were constant. What if there was change in characters in columns? Let's see these patterns now. Now we do know that the column printing is managed by our inner loop. What we see in all of these patterns is all rows start with A and then increment by 1 till end of the row. Let's take one of these as example. Here we have the code for increasing triangle star pattern. So when columns get incremented, instead of initializing P outside the outer loop, we will initialize it as soon as we enter the loop. Moment we enter in the inner loop, we will initialize our variable P to ASCII code 65 for A. We will print char P instead of star. Since now columns are getting incremented, we will move our P plus is equal to 1 statement also inside the inner loop, which handles the column. So let's see how it will work. It will start with the first row and I gets initialized to 0 moment we enter the outer loop. We first initialize P to A, that is 65, and then enter inner loop and print char P. However, the inner loop executes only one time, so we move to the next row with I is equal to 1. It will again initialize P to 65 and then enter inner for loop. It first prints char P, which is A. P is incremented and then in second pass of inner loop, it prints B. It then comes out and in row 2, it prints ABC and in row 3, it prints ABCD and in row 4, it prints ABCDE. Important point to note over here is that P is initialized to 65 or A every time moment you enter inside the outer loop. This cannot be done outside the loop as the loop is executed multiple times and every time you enter a new row, it needs to be initialized back to A. Second thing is we need to increment P every time it is printed. So now our increment statement are inside the inner loop just after every print P statement. Now how does it work for this pattern? Here again we will get our code for this pattern. We will initialize P to 65, moment we enter inside loop. There is no change in the loop for space. We go to the loop which prints star, and instead of star, we will print char p. After printing, we increment p by 1 in inner loop. How does it work for hill pattern? Again, exactly similar. We initialize p to 65 as first line inside the outer loop and then just replace star with char p and increment p after every print p statement. This is the code for the hill pattern. It will work the same for any double row pattern too, like diamond or butterfly. Try it on your own, and if you are facing difficulty, you can see the code on our website. Now what if it was a decreasing pattern? Here let's see two variations of the pattern. One is where it is reducing but starting character is same. Other is where ending character is same, like this one. How will you handle these two? Now the starting character same is very easy and similar to what I showed in incrementing pattern. Just inside the outer loop, you will set p to ASCII code for starting character, which is 69 in this pattern, and then replace all star with char p and decrement p inside inner loop after every print p statement. This logic will work for all pattern shapes. But how to handle when start value is different? Means every time you need to initialize p with different character. It should be E in the first row, D in the second row, and then C, and then B, and then A. The print statement will still remain the same, and there will be decrement of P after the print statement. But how do I give it varying values? Here I will initialize another variable K in outer loop and initialize it with ASCII code E, which is 69. I will use it to initialize P every time. After printing a complete row, in the end, we will decrement k by 1. Why am I not using this variable k only instead of p? Because I am decreasing p in the inner loop. After the first pass, k will be reduced to a and we will not be able to set it back to d then. What if the pattern was a hill pattern like this? You just learned how to do increasing character and decreasing character with variable starting character. We will first get a standard program for hill pattern using star. Now after printing space, first triangle is incrementing character starting with A. So we will initialize a variable p to ASCII value of A, which is 65, and change all print star to char p and increment p by 1 in the inner loop to get left half of the hill. In the next loop, you are actually just decrementing the same p, so we will just replace star with char p and decrement p after the print statement. This should give us the right half and the required hill pattern. Now many times, a word is given to you and you are asked to form a pattern with that specific word. Let's say the word is coder. Now again here, the pattern shape could be asked could be any of these. But if you see, all of them have the same alphabet in each row. Let's pick up this pattern and see how we will solve it. Now in these programs, we will first initialize a string S with the given word outside the loop. Here what you need to remember is that in string, index starts from 0. So first character is at 0 index, then 1 and 2 and so on. Second thing you need to know is that we will use string indexing, which takes in an index to access individual characters. Let's see how we will use it in our program. Now this pattern is incrementing triangle pattern. So first we will get in our standard star program for increasing triangle. Now what we see is in row 0 we have to print character at 0 index. In row 1 character at 1 index and so on. So again we will use another variable p outside the loop and set it to the index of first character, which is 0. Now in the print statement we will just use indexing, means s with square brackets p, to access the character at that index. Once the complete row is printed along with the last print statement, we will increment p index by 1. So here for the first row when p is 0, it will print c for us. For next row when p is 1, it will print o and then d, then e and then r. This is our program for same character in each row. The same logic we can use for any shape which has the same character in each row, like for the right sided triangle or hill pattern or any other pattern. But what if the values were reverse? Again, we see in a row the same character is printed, so we will just set p to the last index, which is n minus 1 or 4. Instead of print star, we will print s with index p and then we will decrement p at the end of each row. This will give us the reverse pattern. This will again work for different patterns with decreasing row character. Now all this was where character in a row were constant. What if there was change in character in columns? Let's see these patterns now. Now we do know that the column printing is managed by our inner loop. What we see in all of these patterns is all rows start with character at 0 index and then index increments by 1 till end of the row. Let's take one of these as example. Here we have the code for increasing triangle pattern where we have initialized the string s outside the loop. So when columns get incremented, instead of outside the loop, we will take the additional variable inside the loop. Moment we enter the first loop, we will initialize our variable p to 0. Our print statement will use s with index p to get the character at the given index. After printing, we will increment p now in the inner loop. This will again work for all different patterns where columns are incrementing. Now what if it was a decreasing pattern? Here let's see two variations of the pattern. One is where it is reducing but starting character or index is same. Other is where ending character or index is same, like this one. How will you handle these two? Now the starting character same is very easy and similar to what I showed in incrementing pattern. You will just set p to starting index, which is n minus 1 or 4 in this pattern, and then replace all star with s index of p. After printing, we will decrement p in the inner loop. This logic will work for all pattern shapes. But how to handle when start value is different? Means every time you need to initialize p with different character, it should be r in the first row, e in the second row, then d, then o, and then c. The print statement will still remain the same, s index of p. How do I give it varying start values? Here I will initialize another variable k outside the outer loop and start with index n minus 1, which is 4. We will use it to initialize p every time we enter the outer loop. Once we move to the next row, we will reduce it by 1 every time. So now we have combination of two variables, one k to decide the first letter of each row and p to handle the decrement of this in each column. You can now try any pattern shapes combined with characters, and if you're facing difficulty, you can always reach out to us at simplycoding.in. Thank you and goodbye.